This is class 9, CBSC, History, French Revolution, part 3. The causes of outbreak of French Revolution. There are four causes. One is political causes, then social causes, economic causes, and intellectual or immediate causes. In that, political causes and social causes we already learned in that previous video. In this video, we are going to learn about the economic causes and intellectual or immediate causes. The struggle to survive. The population of France rose from 23 million in 1715 to 28 million in 1789. So the first thing of the economic causes is the increase of the population from 23 million to 28 million. This led to a rapid increase in the demand for food grains. So the population is increased, so the food grains demand also increased. Production of grains could not keep pace with the demand because the production of grains is low, very less. So it's not keep pace with the demand of the food grains. So the price of bread, which was the staple diet of the majority of France people, rose rapidly. So the demand increased. Automatically, the cost, that is the price of the bread, also increased. Most workers were employed as laborers in workshops whose owner fixed their wages. That means that workers' wages were not increased, but the basic staple food, that is bread, price increased. But wages did not keep pace with the rise in prices. So the gap between the poor and the rich widened. So they enlarged the gap between the poor and rich. Things became worse whenever drought or hail reduced the harvest. Whenever the bad weather condition happened in France, especially drought or hail, so the harvest of the wheat reduced. This led to the subsistence crisis. Economic causes, also known as subsistence crisis. The meaning of subsistence crisis is an extreme situation where the basic means of livelihood, that is basic living standard of the French people, are endangered. Because of the two things, one is lack of food and also the increase the price of the staple diet, staple food, that is bread. Something that occurred frequently in France during the old regime. So these are the important factors of subsistence crisis or economic causes. First one is population, increase of the population from 23 million to 28 million in 1789. Then next one is rapid increase in the demand for food grains. This is second point. Third one is food production of grains could not keep pace in the demand. So that demand is increased, production of grains reduced. Next, so the price of bread, which was stable, it also rose rapidly. So the price of bread is increased. Fourth point, most of the workers were employed, but their owner fixed their wages. So fixed wages, so they did not keep pace with the rise in prices. So the gap between the poor and rich widened. And next one is, seventh point, the drought or hail reduced the harvest. So even the situation turned into worsen. This one is known as subsistence crisis. Here, one activity is given about the subsistence crisis. How a subsistence crisis happened? To fill the boxes, some keywords also given here. We'll fill this in these boxes. First one is bad harvest. So bad harvest, obviously it leads to the scarcity of grain. So first one is scarcity of grain. Next box, so it leads to that raising of food prices. So here they given here raising of food prices. It leads to the poorest can no longer buy bread. Then down, it leads to the food riots. Then weaker bodies. So the poorest can no longer buy bread. So what they will do? They do the food riots, and some persons will there become very weak. So because of this weakness, it leads to the disease epidemics. So finally, increased number of death. This is the activity. A growing middle class envisages an end to privileges. This only known as intellectual or immediate causes. So a growing middle class envisages. That means a desirable future which is expecting by the middle class peoples, those who are growing in the France, that future really were not yet exist. They dreamt of that society be as their own desirable things. They want some changes in the society. And also they want to do that end to privileges, because especially the tax privileges which was enjoyed by that clergy and the noble persons, these privileges they want to keep end to that clergy and nobles. In the past, peasants and workers had participated in revolts against increasing taxes and food scarcity. So in past, before the middle class growing, the peasants as well as the workers participated in revolts against for the two things. One is increasing the taxes and food scarcity. But they lacked the means and programs to carry out full-scale measures that would bring about a change in the social and economic order. But they were lacked because there is no proper team, proper persons or a proper program organizers to do it in a full-scale measures to bring out a great change in social and economic order. This was left to those groups within the third estate who had become prosperous and had access to education and new ideas. So this programs, this work is left to that third estate people itself, that also those who are prosperous, that means those who are educated and have the new ideas. The 18th century witnessed the emergence of social groups, that emergence of new social group only known as middle class group, who earned their wealth through an expanding overseas trade. So they all belongs to traders. From the manufacture of goods such as woolen and silk textiles. So they expand that over trades. From the manufacture of goods such as woolen and silk textiles, so they turned as a wealthy persons. and they were either exported or bought by the richer members of society, and then they did the trade. In addition to merchants and manufacturers, a third estate include some professions, professionists, such as lawyers or administrative officials. All of these were educated and believed that no group in society should be privileged by birth. So no group of the society, especially first estate and second estate, that is clergy, that is Roman Catholic Church people's clergy and noblemen, that is feudal lords or landlords. They want to keep end of their privileges, and also they believe there is no such a group in society should be privileged because of by birth in that group. Rather, a person's social position must depend on its merit. If you want to get any privilege or any important social position, higher position, that must depend on their own merit alone, not by birth. These ideas envisaging a society based on freedom and equal laws and opportunities for all. So they want that society based on freedom, complete freedom, and equality, equal laws, and also opportunities for all the peoples of France were put forward by philosophers, important philosophers such as John Locke and Jean-Jacques Rousseau. In his two treatises of government, a book was written by John Locke, sought to refute the doctrine of divine and absolute right of the monarch. Actually, doctrine of divine, it means the rights of the kings. Actually, they have a theory of kingship. Usually, they are described themselves, the monarch is subject to no earthly authority. They are not subject to any persons. They are sent by the God here on the earth to rule the people. And also they are deriving right to rule directly from the will of God. This is the statement given by the kings. So that one is known as doctrine of divine. This one is, this statement is refused by that John Locke. Another one is absolute right of the monarch. That means complete autocracy under the control of the king. That also John Locke refused it. Rousseau carried the idea forward, proposing a form of government based on a social contract. In his book, he written that one is as a social contract. His book name is Social Contract, between people and their representatives. He proposed a form of government. It should be based on that contract between people and their representatives. Next, Montesquieu. His book, The Spirit of the Laws, proposed a division of power within the government between, that is, we are also following that same system, that is three organs of the government, that is the legislative, the executive, and the judiciary. He mentioned the division of power within the government between the legislative, executive, and judiciary. He don't want that entire authority under the single king. This model of government was put into force in the USA, United States of America, after the 13 colonies declared their independence from Britain. The American Constitution and its guarantee of individual rights. Individual rights means fundamental rights. Each and every individual, every citizen of the country has the equal rights, was an important example for political thinkers in France. So the ideas of these philosophers were discussed intensively in salons and coffee houses and spread among people through books and newspapers. These were frequently read aloud in groups for the benefit of those who could not read and write. So those who could not read and write, those who were not literate, that among that persons, a person read aloud in the groups that books, through the books and newspapers, especially the ideas of the philosophers. The news that Louis XVI planned to impose further taxes, because Louis XVI wanted to increase the taxes to meet his extravagant expenses. To be able to meet the expenses of the state generated anger and protest against the system of privileges. In next video, we will learn about that, the outbreak of the revolution. Until then, thank you.